My lords, it's a pleasure to follow the noble baroness, whom I've got very considerable respect for. But I have to say, in nearly 40 years in Parliament, I have never seen a more badly drafted or dangerous piece of legislation. It consists of two clauses. The noble baroness said the key issue is where you draw the line. And she's absolutely right about that. It's where you draw the line. And unfortunately, this bill does not draw the line. I mean, I refer the House to Clause 1, Section 2. It says, conversion therapy is any practice. What does any practice mean? How is that defined? Does any in practice include a parent not supporting a children's decision to dress as a member of the opposite sex? The noble baroness shakes her head. But where does it say that in the bill? In her speech, she said there were all kinds of understandings and provisions, but it is not there on the face of the bill, and she is asking us to support this bill. Any practice aimed at a person or group, so that includes children. So parents saying to their children, you must not take puberty blockers, they would find themselves on the wrong side of the law. This is an extraordinary suggestion. Or trying to prevent surgery or medical interventions, which would be irreversible. Is that any practice? I mean, if I read the language of the bill, it says, any practice aimed at a person, i.e. children, or a group of people, which demonstrates an assumption. Demonstrates an assumption. Are we now going to criminalise people for thinking things? Because that's what demonstrates an assumption means, that any sexual orientation or gender identity is inherently preferable to another and which was intended for the purpose of attempting to change a person's sexual orientation or gender identity. And what exactly is gender identity? That is not included in the bill. I notice that the Scottish Government currently has a consultation document out in which they attempt to define gender identity, and it is an individual's personal sense of being or belonging to a particular gender or genders or of not having a gender. That is a definition. And we are expected to criminalise people on the basis of something which is so fluid and which is not defined in this bill. I mean, I have to say to the noble baroness, when she said that this is not about attacking free speech, of course it's an attack on free speech if parents can't feel they can give guidance to their children. And it's an absolute basic duty of parents to give guidance to their children and to prevent them from suffering any harm. It criminalises advice given in good faith. Now, I noticed that the bill also applies to Scotland. Now, the Scottish Government have got a consultation document out at the moment. The penalty for telling your child not to take puberty blockers or whatever is a fine at level not exceeding level 5. That is an unlimited fine. I suppose we should be grateful for that, because in Scotland they're proposing 7 years in prison. The world has gone mad. It seems to me that we normally in this House introduce legislation in order to fix a problem, not create new ones. And this undermines the family, attacks free speech, freedom of thought, and even religious belief. It is a dangerous, crude piece of legislation in a hugely complex and controversial area which is not suited to private legislation. It is all the characteristics of something written on the back of a beer mat after an unruly discussion in a pub. I very much oppose it. And if we were able, I know we have a convention in this House that we don't vote against second readings, but if we were to have a divide on it, I would certainly kill it now, for it is a dangerous thing which brings great discredit, I believe, on this House and Parliament as a whole. Yeah.